Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So if you are new here, I'm Suzie and I create contents about work from home, self-development, productivity, and freelancing lifestyle. So if you like those kind of topics, please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the bell button down below so that you'll get notified every time I upload a new video. So right now, yung video natin is just a continuation lang sa tutorials na ginawa ko sa Teach for a Cause, which yung first part is ito. So, if hindi niyo pa napanood yun, you can also check that one out after this one. And in this video, it focuses more on Google Drive management. You can apply this one to your own Google Drive account or your client's Google Drive account. And aside from that, I also focus on how to use Google Form and how you're going to use it and how to consolidate all the answers in the spreadsheet. If you're interested to the topic, please continue watching. Nakagamit na ba kayo ng Google Drive? You can go here sa Google Apps icon and then Google Drive. Again, guys, this is also the same kung magsisave kayo or gagawa kayo ng mga files and folders nyo sa desktop nyo. So, super easy din. And what I like about it is that you can share it to your team and to your clients. So, yan yung gusto ko sa Google Drive. So, here, ito yung Google Drive ko. Wala pa talagang laman. So, I will teach you on how to create folders. So, as you can see, ito yung drive mo. And then, click mo lang, new, and then folder. So, I want you guys to be very organized when it comes to naming. Para hindi kayo malito if you want to search for something, if you want to search for files. Like, for example, this one. I will create personal folder. So, most likely, ang i-upload ko dito, mga bills, mga tracking expenses, yung personal, yung hindi ko necessary i-share sa clients ko. So, yan. Meron din tayong, let's say, if you have another business. Like, let's say, you have an e-commerce store. So, lahat ng details mo or files mo about your e-commerce store, like your high-res logo, high-res banner, dito mo i-upload lahat para hindi ka malito. So, like, for example, ABC store, ganun. An example, if you have other clients then, like freelance clients na naman. So, online clients. So, here, i-click mo ang online clients, tapos dito ka maglagay ng name nila. Like, name of the company or name of the client. Like, for example, client name plus yung company niya. ABC company. So, yan. If marami ka ng clients, hindi ka na maano kung saan yung mga files niya. Kasi, naka-organize lahat. So, for example, this one, you can also put a color. Ako, mahilig talaga ako sa color eh. Parang, mas nagaganahan ako mag-work pag may color. So, for me, I choose pink. And then, here, let's say, blue. And let's say, e-commerce, more money, it's green, charot lang. Charot lang, guys. So, dito mo makikita talaga yung mga folders mo na ginawa mo. So, for example, si Miss May mag-share sa akin ng files or folder, dito ko makikita yon sa shared. Okay, so King Me, maybe you are asking if how to share folders or how to share files. So you can just click it and then share and then just put kung anong email ang gusto niyo, like for this one, and then pwede niyo siyang ilagay as view lang kung ayaw niyo na may galawin siya sa files niyo. Pwede ding organize, add, edit. Kung organize, add, edit, pwede siyang maka-alter sa file mo. Pwede siyang maka-upload sa folder mo. So, you will just hit send. That's how you're going to share your files. Okay, so right now, dito din yung mga recent mo na nakikita and pwede din kayong mag-star. And then yung trash kung meron kayong i-remove na file. So here, I'm going to teach you on how to create, like for example, sa folder, itong Google Docs, katumbas to siya ng Microsoft Word. So, I will just let you see. Sample title. This is just a sample title, guys. This is just really basically kung ano yung Microsoft Word. And if you want to share it, you can just click share button here. And then lagay mo na naman yung email. Like for example, ganyan. Don't forget, guys, if ever gusto nyo na maka-edit siya, ito, kung gusto nyo maglagay lang siya ng comment, ito, kung gusto nyo mag-view lang siya, wala siyang galawin, huwag nyo talaga itong kalimutan. Kasi baka may ma-edit siya, tapos hindi nyo naman ginawa yung mga ganun. So, yeah. So, send mo lang, and then makakatanggap siya ng notification na nag-share ka ng file sa kanya. So, I also made quick tutorial dito sa YouTube ko, pero what I'm doing there is I'm teaching on how to create a CV using Google Doc template. And also, another sample is here, the Google Sheet. Google Sheet is really the same also sa Microsoft Excel. So, kung nakagamit na kayo nun, this one is also very pretty easy to use. And the same lang din sa Google Doc. Dito yung title. Ilagay mo yung title dito. Then, pwede din kayong makalagay ng formula dito. Just really the same sa Microsoft Excel. Can also put here another sheet. So, you can rename the sheet name. And then, you can, by the way, guys, you can download this one sa Excel format. Pwede din sa PDF. The same din dito sa Google Doc. You can also download your work here sa Microsoft Word na file or sa PDF. It's up to you. So here, may Google Slides din tayo. Itong Google Slides, super the same din siya sa Microsoft PowerPoint. So, pwede kang mamili ng mga themes here kung ano yung gusto mo. And you can also import theme kung meron kang ma-download sa Google. And very the same lang din siya ng idea sa spreadsheet and then sa doc natin. And then, the same din if you want to share it here. And if you want to download it dito sa file and then download. Then, Microsoft PowerPoint ba or PDF ba? Ginagamit ko din to madalas ang Google Form and Google Site. So, Google Form muna tayo. Sa Google Form, most likely, ito yung ginagamit if you want to get an input from other people or answer from other people. Like, let's say here, sample form, yan. And then, you can put a short description here about sa mga itatanong mo. I will just put something para makita niyo. Sample description. Tapos dito, question, for example, I want to get the email first. Gusto ko malaman kung anong email na ginagamit na magsasagot dito. So, this one, automatic na lalabas to, enable email, collecting setting. You will just have to click that one, and then automatic na magkukuha siya ng email. If I need more input, like, click ko lang yung ito, add question, full name. Automatic dito, short answer. And then, I can also create this one as a require. So, lahat ng magsasagot or makakatanggap ng form na to, kailangan or required nilang sagutan ang email address at yung full name. Okay, so I will add another sample here. Like for example, tapos, ang ilagay natin is yung multiple choice. Tapos, ito yung option 1. You can also add another option 2. And then, option 3. And it's up to you kung dagdagan nyo pa or hindi na. You can also make this required if you want. Pero kung hindi na, okay lang din. And also, pwede nyo ding mag-add ka ng text, another text or another title and description. You can also add an image. You can also add a video. And meron ding separator. So for example, ito lang yung ilagay natin. Ito yung kalabasan niya. So this one, pwede natin tong i-change if you want. Customize natin. Gusto ko yung ganun. And then add. Yan. And then, pwede din tayong maglagay ng header. So, ang header dito sa itaas. So, example, kung maglalagay kayo ng header, guys, kailangan din na related din siya sa mga questions nyo, okay? Hindi nice na maglagay ng mga foods, pero ang question mo is more on from working from home, yung mga ganun, diba? So, let's just put something like this na lang. If you want to see the preview, just click the I here. Yan. Tapos, makikita mo yung preview dito. So, try natin kung magsisend tayo ng sample. For example, fill upan natin siya kung ano ba yung lalabas sa email. So, yan. Then, click send. Yun na natin sa email ko. So, this is the sample form. So, ito yung lalabas sa akin. Sample form, sample description. If I'm going to fill it out, so, lalagay ko yung email, address ko, my name, let's just say, Sui. And then, ito, pwede ko siyang sagutan, pwede hindi, kasi wala naman siyang star dito sa itaas. Hindi natin siya nilagay as required. So, I will just put option 1 and then click submit. So, nasubmit na sa form. So, dito natin makikita yung response sa gilid. So, here, yung email ko, yung full name, and then yung question na nilagay ko. Option 1 yung pinili ko. That's why blue yung 100%. So, yeah, that's that. You can also connect that one para ma-consolidate yung mga answers. For example, you are sending it to 20 people. Para ma-consolidate lahat ng mga answers nila, you can create a new spreadsheet here. Like for this one, sample form. Create a new spreadsheet. Pero kung may nagawa na kayong spreadsheet, you can also select this one. Select existing. Since hindi naman tayo gumawa, so I will just create a new spreadsheet. So create. So automatic na lalabas dito yung mga sagot ko. So, every time na may mag-answer doon, lalabas siya dito. I will put this here sa chat box and try natin. Ayun! So, ato, may nag-answer na si Chris. So, the same yung response niya, option 1. So, dito, nakikita din natin yung mga sagot nila. So, that's the purpose. So, madalas ko itong ginagamit kasi yung client ko always nag-a-ask ng mga inputs ng mga followers nila. So, I'm using this one kasi very easy to use lang and very easy to manage. Dito din, guys, dito nyo makikita yung consolidated form. Yung sample form natin, di ba gumawa tayo ng sample spreadsheet? So, dito siya malalagay. Kung saan folder mo ginawa yung form, doon din lalabas yung sample spreadsheet form mo. So, yeah, that's that. And also, guys, sometimes I also use this one, Google Sites. This is good for beginners, especially if you want to showcase your portfolio. So, maganda to siya. Para talaga siyang website. And what I like about it is that kasi drag and drop lang siya. So, for example, this one, I will put this layout. I will just drag and drop. And kung gusto ko maglagay ng picture, upload ko lang dito. And then I can edit the text. Pwede din akong makapag-choose ng mga font, ano kalaki, yung mga ganun. This is very easy to use and user-friendly. And hindi lang siya for home. Pwede ka ding maka-add ng other new page, like about me. Pwede ka ding mag-add dito ng about me. And then, you can also change the theme. Though the theme, very konti lang. Pero, pwede na din. para mas formal lang yung pag-present yun ng portfolio, especially if hindi pa kayo sanay gumamit ng WordPress or hindi pa kayo sanay gumamit ng ibang platforms na pwede nyo ma-showcase yung portfolio nyo. So this one, I would really highly recommend it. Pwede nyong malagay din dito yung G Drive nyo, which is very easy to access. Para sa mga clients na gustong maka-work with you, gusto kang ma-hire, makita nila agad yung mga nagawa mo na sinave mo lang sa Drive mo. Yeah, I guess that's pretty much that. So yeah, thank you for watching the whole video. Hope you learned a lot from that. And so if you are following our tutorials about Google Drive management, don't forget to screenshot your Google Drive dashboard so that I can see that you are really following our tutorials, and upload it on our Facebook group so that I can include it into our Boss Up Spotlight. So speaking of that, before I'm going to end this video, I'm going to feature all the boss babes and bosses inside our Facebook group na fina-follow talaga yung mga tutorials natin dito. So, check this out! So if you like to be featured as well, don't forget to join our Facebook group. Just search I'm Ready to Boss Up by Britx to Facebook and join that one. You just have to answer a couple of questions, then you're in. And follow me on my Instagram account as well, Britx. And yeah, see you guys on the next one.